WGAL News 8 Sports, powered by Xfinity Mobile.
Welcome back. I'm Bethany Miller. We begin tonight out at the Giant Center in the final game of the weekend. Central York facing Parkland in the boys 6A state championship. The Panthers looking to make history tonight and become the first York County team to win a state title in Class 6A. Trailing by one early as Ben Natal hits the top of the key three to give Central York a 10-8 lead. Later, Ben Rill, a nice move in the lane here. It's the tough basket to fall. So time is ticking down in the first half. Greg Gittinger, the soft touch. The Panthers go into the locker room up 10, 34-24. Everyone absolutely fired up after that. Now Parkland would retake the lead in the fourth quarter. So Central York trailing by two with under five to go. Ryan Brown, the clutch triple, puts the Panthers back up one. So now up two. Natal driving in and finishes the tough layup through traffic. Make that a 4-point Central York lead. But the Trojans, Nick Koval cuts back door, draws the and one to bring Parkland within two. 1 minute remaining in regulation. So 53-51, Panthers still leading. Parkland with a chance at the buzzer. But it's off the rim. And Central York makes history tonight at the Giant Center. Jacob Paul was in Hershey and brings us the sights and sounds from the celebration.
No public school in York County had ever won a state basketball championship until today. Central York defeats Parkland 53-51 at the Giant Center to win the 6A state championship.
This is for all of York County. Bringing home the first York County state championship in basketball, it means everything to us. Like I said, the hard work and dedication, the sacrifices we've made, the early mornings.
You know, a lot of people came out here and showed us love, even for people that didn't go to our school, because this is not something that happens a lot. So for people to come out here and support us, it means a lot.
It's the best feeling in the world, just because, you know, it came down to how hard we wanted to work. And I've been telling you, these last couple interviews, that it's not going to come down to our talent. It's going to come down to the hard work. And by no means was it a perfect game. You know, we had some rough quarters, some rough possessions, but not once did I falter or worry about what my guys can do and, you know, their ability. And that's just as a testament to how much we've matured, how much we've grown.
We've handled adversity throughout the whole season, so this was nothing new. But a state championship game, we knew it was going to be tough. This is the last game of the season. We had to leave everything on the floor, and that's what we did. We got the win.
So when you look back on this team in 5, 10, 15 years, what are you going to remember the most?
They're just great kids. Like, I love them so much. They all have big hearts. Like, they sit together at lunch. They talk to each other. They know each other. They support each other. It's the most selfless group of people that have the biggest hearts around. That's what I'm going to remember. You couldn't ask, like, to be around better people.
And there were only two seniors on this roster. Greg Gittinger was the only starter. So this team will have all the talent to run it back again next year. At the Giant Center, Jacob Hall, WGAL News 8.